the fans are what make you. So you gotta.
Here you have Frank Sanchez heading to the weigh-in. Lupe, what can we expect? He's fighting Nadia Galera.
Frank, ¿quieres saber qué es lo que va a pasar en tu pelea mañana?
Mañana voy a no cao, voy a salir del trabajo. Wow. Todo el trabajo que he hecho voy a salir en el trabajo, en la pelea.
He said he's going to knock him out. He's going to show all the work he's been doing.
Now, sitting near you, Lupe, is Dr. Rod all the way from Vegas. He's a huge boxing fan. He went to UC Irvine. He knows the sport.
Sir.
Ask him a trivia question about boxing, Lupe.
Okay, because I'm Filipino, I have to ask a Filipino maybe a Pacquiao question.
Yeah.
How many weight classes has Pacquiao?
Eight.
Very good.
What do you guys think about Canelo Billy Joe?
Eighth round knockout.
It's going to be a good fight. I like, of course, all week we've seen a lot of chatter going back and forth, but you know, that's all for the show. Let's just see what it is in the ring.
I got a question for you. How many times does Julio Cesar Chavez fight defend his world titles?
Oh.
115 fights total.
Yeah.
So how many?
Oh, I got an easier one. How many fights did he go undefeated?
Oh,
come on.
No, double that almost.
Is it?
89-0.
Oh.
Frank, you know, I'm sorry.
First loss was against Frankie Randa.
Oh,
Frank, did you know Julio was 89-0?
Que si sabías que el viejito allá enfrente peleó 89-0 antes de perder.
90-0, güey.
Wow. 89, ¿no?
Pero empató, pero 90.
Oh, 90?
Wow.
Oh, it was 89-0 and then he tied fight number 90.
That's
so he didn't lose.
Mucho fights.
90-0
and 1 draw. And Frank, what do you think? Canelo, Billy Joe, your prediction?
Canelo's gonna win by knockout.
Sí, but Willie, ya perdió desde aquí abajo buscando excusas en ring ya. Ya está ya perdido desde aquí abajo.
Hey Lupe, this was the shortest ride in the history of rides from hotels to venues.
Yeah.
It's like one block. 70,000 fans tomorrow.
Ask Juan Carlos about his fighter. He's got somebody.
Juan, who you got on the card tomorrow?
Edwin Soto.
What can you tell us about him? Great kid, great fighter?
Great kid, great fighter. Great matchup. The Japanese has been a world champion a couple of times. He was preparing actually for the Olympics, but he took this fight. It's going to be a really, really good fight, but Edwin Soto is in his prime, and I think he's gonna win. By probably 9-10 rounds.
Hopefully.
There you have it.
Yes.
There you have it, Frank Sanchez.
There you have it.
Right here.
Elie Seckbach
reporting. By the way, Lupe, if you want to get in shape, Chavez Sr. has a new app. What's the app?
What are you suggesting, Elie?
No, I'm not suggesting. I'm just saying. I'm just saying there's a new app if you want to get in shape.
Already?
Wow, look how many fans, that's crazy. Man.
There you go, Frank.
Canelo's a rock star. Look at this, a sea of people.
Oh, this is the land.
Oh.
There we go. Frank Sanchez in the house. Cesar Chavez.
Let's go.
Frank. Right. Pero, pégatele a Julio. So, stay next to Julio.
Yeah, that's
Wow.
Prediction, prediction.
Obviamente va a ganar Canelo, ese papá de Canelo.
Knockout? Does he knock out Billy Joe? We're here at the weigh-in. What's going on? What do you feel? A lot of people, thousands.
A lot of people just ready to weigh in. High for tomorrow night. 5,000 people just come to see us weigh in.
Amazing energy.
About to start right now.
Let's go. And someone's gonna be lucky they're getting your shirt. You're gonna throw it off into the crowd.
Let's get you on this side of it.
They met them yesterday. They said, I got an invitation from Billy Joe Sanders. Here's my email. They go, I don't care who invited you. Eddie Hearn says you gotta get the fuck out. Get out. No, but I got invited by Tyson Fury too. Look, I got the email. Eddie Hearn says you gotta get the fuck out. They escorted it out.
So Mikey, how are you feeling? 5,000 fans out here, it's exciting. The fans are going crazy for you in Texas. They love you. It's like your home away from home.
Fans are always good. You know, Texas has been a big boxing, community, boxing state all over Texas. You know, and a lot of Hispanics, especially for this. You know, you got Canelo here, biggest Mexican, fighter. You know, the fans obviously follow me as well, so
great. I'm gonna tell you what's crazy. I was telling you, just being around you, Robert, and Brandon, I said, I don't care what Billy Joe Saunders says, you're not going to get him to the head of a Mexican fighter. You don't care what they say.
We don't focus on that. We do our talking inside of the ring. Canelo's going to do the same thing on Saturday night, tomorrow night.
What's your prediction?
I keep saying this. In the earlier half of the fight, I could see Saunders maybe winning 2, possibly 3 rounds, being a little competitive, but then halfway, the 6th round, Canelo starts to pick up the pace, starts to close the gap, Canelo takes over and wins the decision. But I could also see Canelo stopping Saunders somewhere in the 10th round.
Have you ever been mad at an opponent that you wanted to hurt him, like Eloy Rojas or one of those? No? Never?
No.
What about this? Mayweather, Logan Paul, Jake Paul took his hat, I got your hat. Did you see any of that, Mikey?
I saw a little bit on the phone. Man, them Paul brothers are great for marketing. They know what the fuck to do.
Geniuses.
They're some of the best, YouTubers in the world. So he knew that was going to create all this buzz, all this hype. He's got you asking me about it, so.
He took mine with his hat. You like hats. If someone took your hat, you're going to mess him up.
Yeah, you're going to get mad, it was part of, Paul's idea,
Grab Marco's hat really quick. Let's see. Mac, I got your hat. Oh, he's on the phone. But tomorrow you're broadcasting everybody, the Zone?
We're doing the Spanish broadcast for the Zone. So anybody that wants to tune in on the Zone on Spanish, you'll be listening to me.
Any updates on what's next for Mikey Garcia?
Not yet, but
stay tuned.
We're staying sharp, we'll be back.
Hopefully Pacquiao, but
Hopefully.
Stay tuned.
That's a plan.
But there you have it, Mikey, stay tuned. So hopefully back in Texas, because you got a lot of love here. I was telling people before I turned on the camera, that Tyson Fury was outside the hotel with fans. They were all surrounding him. You walked out of the hotel. All the fans left Tyson Fury and ran here. And Tyson was like, Mikey, what are you doing?
You got Hispanic, Mexican fans, Latino fans. They recognize me. They're going to say hi to me.
They've been following you for years.
Of course.
Then Tyson Fury asked you if you want to spar him. Because he saw the video of you knocking out heavyweights.
I went up to him to say what's up to him, you know.
Yeah.
And he's like, how you doing, Mikey Garcia? You know, I need some sparring. I'm like, oh, I'm almost your size. He's like, I need someone that's quick. I'm like, yeah.
That's funny.
He's a character. He's a character.
They're booing someone right now.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.